Kenny, bud. Pre-season 23-24, how have you been finding it so far?
Good. It's magic. It's absolutely beautiful weather. The sun's been splitting the trees and the ground's solid. But it's been brilliant. The boys have been absolutely amazing. They've worked so hard and they're looking in great shape. The gaffer's got them working hard every session and the boys are playing with a smile on their face. They're brilliant, aren't they?
I've got to say that I have to contradict you about the weather. It's been absolutely pouring during the day.
Aye, the day's the worst day of the day.
And it's bloody Baltic.
I'm no cold.
And we've been eaten alive by midges.
No.
And they haven't cut the grass, but apart from that, it's been brilliant.
Ah, right off, the surface isn't the best, to be honest. But get boys the lawnmowers out.
Boys are looking
Graham
fit.
Glenn.
Boys are looking fit. Really good results on the yo-yo test, I know.
Aye.
Better than last year's.
Aye. They're up and down, though.
Up and down, like
down,
a yo-yo. That bodes well. After last season's exploits, of course, we were super fit.
Oh, magnificent fitness last year. To go to the end, to go and win that league, it was amazing.
Ask us another.
Any goalkeeper coach take part in the yo-yo test?
Yes.
Absolutely.
I took part. Level 3. I had to pull out because my ankle was playing up again. So,
well, his ankle was playing up again, but that's got something to do. That's another story. That's more
alcohol.
Off-season related. But I'll come to that later on, though.
Yeah, of course, two new lads in so far, Lisman and Dale Hilson. How do you feel they've settled into the squad so far?
Yeah, they've got white bibs on the day, so they've settled in beautiful. They look great with their suntans, they look great. They're good. Him and Jack and Lewis look the same, they've got the hairbands. Oh, they're going to have the hairbands this year.
They're having a Love Island off.
Oh, they do good looking boys, too.
But they need a boy themselves on the pitch. To meet you.
Outstanding, weren't they?
Really, really good.
Fast feet, touch pass.
And Dale Hilson. Obviously, a rap block boy.
Who's that?
Still got your watch. You watch him?
No, rap block.
That's
a hip.
Sorry, any rap block people. Oh, his stomach.
Oh, is it? Oh, right.
Oh, he's a local boy. A huge Stirling Albion fan, he tells us.
Aye.
Could be a huge liar as well, though, I'm not sure. But really, really fit. Good guy.
Very good guy.
They've slotted in perfectly to a really good dressing room. That's.
Nice boys as well, that's a good thing. They need to come into this group of boys. These group of boys are the best you'll ever get. They all got on well and they're absolutely so funny as well. And these two guys have come in and been outstanding as well.
We're funnier than them.
Oh, we are
funnier than them.
But you, I think the last one was funny. Part 2 is always harder than part 1,
like,
isn't it? Lethal Weapon 1 was good, but Lethal Weapon 2.
Same with Dumb and Dumber.
Dumb and Dumber 1, Dumb and Dumber 2.
Godfather was alright.
The God or the God?
The God.
Alright.
Something fishy going on there, sorry.
Yeah, of course you mentioned the lads there in the dressing room. How does this dressing room compare to some of the ones you've worked in your careers?
I'm taking care of this one.
Oh, you're in this one, eh?
This is the best dressing room that I've been in.
Seats are nice, aren't they?
Lovely, comfortable.
The seats are nice and comfortable. But wallpaper's nice.
I thought the Queen of the South one, early 2000s, would no be beaten.
But it's painted that now.
And, this has been brilliant. Really, really good.
Yeah, it's the best. Had a great one at Pisco as well and it was magnificent, but this is unbelievable. Honestly, the guys are special.
Yeah, of course, such a successful season last season. What's your some of your highlights from that season?
Highlights? Please don't go highlights.
Off here.
My biggest highlight was the day the whistle went against Annan when we won it. That was my highlight. I had my wee tear in my eye. That's when all the hard work to get everybody behind the scenes, the previous support board, everybody, the new board, every board,
Highland board.
It was just incredible. That's the biggest highlight. Just that whistle went and it was ours and they deserve it. All the players worked so hard, the gaffer, Jamesy, Doc, Kenny, Matty, the other guys, the ladies, the tea ladies.
Stu.
He doesn't work hard. That big man just moans for fun, doesn't he? But honestly, that, then Dale's goal against Steny.
Well, that's my highlight. Dale's goal. That's what summed up the season for me, that goal. And I think I nearly hit the centre circle when that went in.
I do.
Roy, I was pigeon there. No, it's Seagulls.
Seagulls.
As our ex Hibs chairman once said, there was over exuberance. and I was part of that. It must be in the blood to be a fan of another team as well. But I definitely, that's my highlight, that and the crowd behind the goal.
The Annan game as well, yeah. When Big Mark came on, made his debut. Then the Stranraer game when Blair makes a last minute penalty. And then Dale's goal.
Just up with goalies.
It is up with goalies because they don't get the recognition that they deserve. But we have got four brilliant goalies. And just, honestly, that day, and then lifting the trophy that day was incredible.
Great.
Absolutely incredible. Celebrations in that changing room will live you forever. Brilliant.
Especially the wee tractor.
The tractor.
The Ockenshugel's tractor.
Mr. Chow on the tractor. Naked. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Don't ask who Mr. Chow is, but he's a goalkeeper. And his first name rhymes with hair.
Hair?
Yeah, of course, at the end of all season as well, there's getting a lads holiday. Did anyone go anywhere nice?
Yeah, I went to Tenerife.
I went to Bulgaria. But we both went to...
Cheap.
It was very cheap, it was good. I conquered Europe, mate. Right. And we went to Albufeira.
The Gal. We call it the Gal. The Portugal.
Portugal. We went to Albufeira with the whole squad. A couple of non-runners for various reasons.
Definitely. Missed them.
But what a laugh.
What a holiday that was.
Absolutely.
And that Saturday brilliant. We lived with everybody because it was such a laugh and everybody got on well. And
so good.
Oh, it was absolutely amazing.
And it was just an extension of the changing room. It was just like that again.
The dancing was good, the banter was good, the beer, the tequila sunrises, the... What was the other one?
Blue Lagoons.
The Blue Lagoons. They were good.
I was drinking Blue Lagoons. But there's so many personalities in there. And everybody had their 5 minutes of madness on holiday. But there's got to be a special mention for a man who's departed now, the eternal student, Mr. Double D, Danny Denham.
Love Double D's day.
He was my soulmate, mate. Have you got a bra for?
Oh, what's a bra for? Danny Denham.
Danny was man of the match in Portugal.
And his t-shirt with the big hyena on it with the orange socks.
And he had orange Fitmore socks. He dresses. He's sponsored by a charity shop, 100%.
Oh, he's
a tramp. He's a tramp. Right? No getting away from it. Some of his gear, you're looking gone.
His banner was outstanding.
And we had a minute of silence for him over there. Yeah. When
Portugal.
Obviously, he was leaving. We had a minute of silence. Closely followed by a minute's applause, because we realised he was gone as well. So
thanks, Danny.
But no, he was brilliant. And he's a miss. But obviously, that's football that happens, you know.
Stories or possibly tattoos that are suitable for social media.
Well, this American guy came out and watched last year and he was supporting the binos.
Am I right in thinking that Beano's has got an apostrophe in it?
Nope. Kenny's arse has got an apostrophe on it. With binos.
Somebody stupidly went drunk.
Oh, look at this. The man ate the bile ham raw.
Somebody stupidly got a tattoo on their bottom with Beano's on it, but it has an apostrophe in it for some reason. But I don't think they regret it.
No, it was...
I don't. Here's Ockenshugel going for me.
Oh, the tractor boy. Up, up. How's your hands?
And
to be fair, it's a shambles. It's a shambles.
Somebody got it done, and you know, they should know better. They should grow up.
Yeah, and of course, new season's around the corner. What are your expectations for going into this tough league?
I think we're looking to get minimum playoffs. That's what we want to do. We've got a good enough squad. I think the boys are right up for the fight. It's going to be hard against four or five full-time teams, but it's got a great bunch of guys and they're great footballers as well. It's good guys.
We're coming into this league with no fear. We've got momentum on our side.
We've got momentum. We signed Mark Weir.
We're coming in with this belief that we've got coming over to last season, obviously. And do you know, see when a team have got that belief, see if you actually can all buy into it, special things can happen, you know.
Yeah.
So not to fear. Obviously respect every other team that's in there, but let's go and do it, let's go and give it our best to see where it takes us. You never know where it'll take us.
Team spirit, and that's better than having probably 20 messages in your team, or momentum in your team, but the team spirit, that's what these boys have got, and they're going to carry on all the way through, and good footballers, we can't forget about that, they're really good, talented footballers, and good cameraman. That'll get us through the season as well, because we need a good cameraman. You know, Eddie?
Adolf.
Adolf?
Yeah, and of course, Friday just there, the League One fixtures came out, starting at home to Edinburgh City. What's your message to the fans ahead of the new season?
Get behind us. We love the banner, the boys, the girls, all the ladies and that, all come out and support us. It's been absolutely amazing. You hear that crowd the last couple of games of the season when we were in the trophy. Take that into the game, the lifts the players, it's brilliant. I mean, I don't know, it was FC Edinburgh or Edinburgh FC?
Oh, they're back to Edinburgh.
They're back to Edinburgh.
So
we're playing Edinburgh City now. But they need to come and back us, because we need them. Club needs them.
Hey, see when the fans get behind the team, the boys are talking about it, they really feel it, and it does get that wee extra percentage for you to go. And you know, we want, obviously we're the only pitch in the
grass pitch, only grass pitch.
The grass pitch in the league.
Fantastic grass pitch with Graham Blount.
No.
Bit of the dog.
But Barley.
Barley?
No, Bailey.
Marley.
Barley.
Barley.
But so teams will want to come and play us at home at our place because we've got a nice pitch. But see if we can get our fans behind us.
Oh, that'd be great.
And just get that wee bit extra. Then,
brilliant.
And as you say, but the end of the season, the terms are brilliant.
Oh, absolutely
superb.
Young team. Don't the young team.
Oh, no, I like
stop
what they've
throwing pyrotechnics.
Aye, stop that. And pies. Don't throw pies.
No, we want pies.
I'll throw them to the bench if you're going to throw them. And stop running the pitch, man.
Oh, no.
Leave it to us, running the pitch. But no, really, really, load of relief. First five fixtures are as hard as they come, actually. But why not? Bring it on, that's what we worked hard for. Do you know that guy?
Good guy.
League One.
Oh, League One, aye, that's
you know
that's Chinese
one.
Laddie.
League
aye.
One. Aye.
That's where we're going to for a dinner tonight, isn't it?
League One.
Flew flung dung, shutting the ball.
Oh, shut up.
That's a perfect example there, guys.
Stealing money by robbing banks.
How much of that is going to have to get cut out?
Oh, hundreds of it.
Quite a bit.
Thank you.